Welcome! OHRP's Division of Policy and Assurances provided this tutorial to help explain some of the requirements relating to Institutional Review Board, IRB, registrations and step-by-step instructions for the IRB registration process. Let's get started! All IRBs that review non-exempt human subjects research conducted or supported by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, referred to as HHS, must register with the Office for Human Research Protections, OHRP. You will need the following information to register an IRB. Name and address of the organization that operates the IRB. Contact information for the organization's senior or head official. The contact person providing the registration information. Each IRB name and location. Each IRB chairperson's name and contact information. Approximate number of all active protocols and approximate number of active protocols that are conducted or supported by HHS. Number of full-time equivalent positions, or FTEs, devoted to the IRB administrative activities. IRBs who must submit IRB membership information should include their voting and alternate IRB members' name, sex, earned degree, whether he or she is a scientist or non-scientist, his or her primary specialty, and if she or he is affiliated with the IRB institution or organization. Institutions must register an IRB using the electronic submission system. An IRB registration is active for 3 years. An update must be submitted within 90 days after a change occurs in the information provider or an IRB chairperson. After processing the initial registration, any update or renewal to the registration information on your organization's IRB also must be done electronically through the electronic submission system. At this point, we are going to talk about the process of registering a new IRB. Using this webpage, your organization can register an IRB if it has never been assigned an IORG number by OHRP and never registered an IRB. You can view the instructions for registering a new IRB at www.hhs.gov/OHRP/assurances/IRB/register/index.html. Obtaining a submission number is the first step in registering an IRB. Once you initiate a submission number request, your submission number will remain valid for 30 days. Please do not request multiple submission numbers for one institution. In order to obtain an electronic submission number, please follow the instructions below. Go to ohrp.cit.nih.gov/e-file/irb-start.aspx. Then, scroll down to the bottom of the web page and select, I need a submission number. A new page will open. In this page, enter the following in the appropriate fields. Your email address, a password that contains at least one uppercase letter, at least one lowercase letter, at least one number or special character, and a minimum of 7 characters and a maximum of 15 characters. A password hint that cannot be the same as the password. Check your email for an automated message from the system. This email will contain your submission number. Once your submission number request is processed, you will receive an automatically generated email with a submission number within 24 to 48 hours from the electronic submission system. If you do not receive the automatically generated email by then, contact OHRP for assistance. Be sure you have saved your submission number for later use. If you lose your submission number, please return to the IRB section of the electronic submission system. Scroll down to Forgot Your Submission Number and/or Password and enter your email address and click Submit. You will receive your submission number via email. Go back to the homepage of the electronic submission system, ohrp.cit.nih.gov/e-file/irb-start.aspx. Please be sure to select New IRB. Then scroll down to the bottom of the webpage and select I have a submission number. To file a new IRB registration, log in using the submission number that the electronic submission system sent to you and the password that you have created. You may begin entering information for an electronic submission and then find that you are not ready to submit it to OHRP for review. In this case, you may save the data entered and return at a later time to complete the submission. Once you get to the Register IRB tab in the section called Register IRB for the following institution or organization, select the Add IRB button. The rest of the application is straightforward. You will need to be sure all required asterisk fields are completed. Once you have entered information on each screen and proofread all data fields, click on the Save and Continue button to move to the next section. When all entries are made, please proofread all fields of the IRB registration form and roster if applicable to ensure the accuracy of the data, and then click Submit and Print IRB Registration. After you select Submit, your application will be reviewed by OHRP within 7 to 10 business days. Once OHRP accepts your registration, the following people will receive an email: the organization's head official, the organization's information provider, and the IRB chairperson. Of course, this is dependent upon correct email addresses being provided for each of these individuals. This concludes steps for registering a new IRB. In closing, the process for updating IRB registrations is similar. To view the update or renewal instructions, please visit www.ohrp/register-irbs-and-obtain-FWAS/IRB-registration/update-renew-registration/index.html. The submission number is valid until OHRP processes the IRB registration associated with that submission number. After processing of an electronically submitted IRB registration, you must request a new submission number for subsequent updates or renewals. Also, please do not attempt to update or renew an IRB registration when there is a pending electronic submission for your organization. The changes you request with each electronic submission are not effective until the IRB registration has been processed. When the IRB registration is processed, you will receive an email notification. That concludes our review of the IRB registration process. We hope you found it helpful. Visit OHRP's website, www.hhs.gov/OHRP, for additional information. Thank you.